God used it to mean really to make us start the war, but not to go too far before we are ready.
While addressing the mourners at the state funeral service of the late General Eli Tumwine, President Yoweri Museveni revisited his memory on the genesis of the NRA liberation struggle and how General Tumwine came to fire the first bullet. Museveni noted that Tumwine's shooting was not a good thing for the war because it frustrated their ploy to steal guns from Kabamba Military Academy.
When Tumwine fired, there was a Tanzanian corporal who was near the armory. He heard the shot, he saw Magara's vehicle rushing, he went inside the armory and got a machine gun. So by the time the group went there, the man was already inside, and this is a concrete bunker. So after we were blaming Tumwine that he had panicked. He should not have fired, he should have wrestled with the man physically.
However, Museveni noted that Tumwine's shooting was a blessing in disguise because the NRA then had no manpower to use the guns they wanted to grab. He says God used Tumwine to shoot in a panic to delay the war, but to give fighters time to organize themselves because later they came back and routed the same guns when they had built enough capacity.
On the 9th, the Tanzanians attacked us. And that's why I'm telling you about God. God used Tumwine to spoil the plan so that we don't capture the guns, and the guns are then recaptured by the Tanzanians because we had no manpower to carry the guns. That's why I'm telling you that really God works in amazing ways.
Museveni hailed Tumwine's contribution in the war, mentioning several success operations he championed and secured victory for the guerrillas.
So again, I sent him Mgume Chaga, you go. He went. He went and the soldiers were coming from drinking. He joined them and went and stayed near the barracks. Until morning, there was no alert. So we came. But it was a big success. We had 760 guns from there. This is Tumwine's work, Masindi.
He eulogized him as a resilient man who sacrificed everything for the war that brought NRM to power, mentioning a moment when the four-star general lost his eye but did not abandon fighting.
He was injured. He was brought by our network. Dr. Gwasaze, there were people who were looking after him. Dr. Gwasaze, They looked after him until he healed and came back and joined us. He didn't say, because I've been injured, let me stay out. No. He came back and continued and has been continuing.
To the family of the deceased, Museveni extended his condolences and urged family members to ignore the people who are using social media to mock General Tumwine.
On General Tumwine, dying at 68, he was still young, but he had achieved a lot. And I'm very happy to hear people saying that he died a satisfied man. That's what Enos is the one who was saying that he died a satisfied man. So with these few words, may the Almighty God rest his soul in eternal peace.
The First Lady, Janet Museveni, also expressed deep sympathies and heartfelt condolences to the family of the deceased and urged them to seek comfort in God to overcome the sad moment.
And we come together to bring our heartfelt condolences also to the family of Eli Tumwine and to stand with them in this hour of grief for having lost a loved one. The NRM and UPDF family celebrate the life of Eli Tumwine for his outstanding service among the leaders of officers and men who are a distinguished force of UPDF. And for the family of Eli Tumwine, I know that there is nothing that can comfort you or fill the gap that Tumwine has left behind in your family.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.